It's a subtle.
I know, the difference in pressure means there's more vibration on one side, and that allows it to turn.
Yeah.
So by adjusting the pressure on one or other side with these stiff rubber grommets or whatever they are, silicon grommets, it will vary the turning motion. Frequency 168.9 or 168.5. So it's tuning it for resonance, so it doesn't have a harmonic. He's like, whoa, 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 whoa. It might have been a beat frequency between the two, but he's got a different frequency today. So he's tuning it.
Yes.
He's mysterious.
Okay, so magnesium chloride, 30 grams per liter. Okay, so 150 grams because, well, hold on. Yeah, so that's 3 times 5 is 15. So 150 grams. 5 liters of pure water, deuterium oxide, 50 grams. And the frequency is tuned this time to 168.5 hertz. So this is the magnesium chloride, MgCl2. And yeah, 150.4, okay. He tuned it to a different frequency, did you see that? And also, yeah, and also he makes the rotation based on screwing these different nuts. So they've got different tensions on one side or the other. And that causes a stirring motion. Suhas had the stirring motion in his thing as well, so.
It's very clever. Actually,
it's very simple, there's a lot you can do with it.
Thank you.
if it changes is when he puts the chemical in. This is good, actually, if you can monitor it whilst he's putting the chemical in. See if it changes when he puts the deuterium oxide in. Something going through the frame, maybe? I don't know.